how many dimensionless parameters can you have in your model? In a complicated model, it's maybe difficult to see at the first glance. Fortunately, you have a theorem for this, Buckingham's theorem. You will see the theorem and how to use it in this video. We'll use an example just to show how it works. This video is not about this example, it's just as an illustration. We use our good old Darcy for that. V equals minus 1 over mu times k, where k is the 3x3 matrix now, permeability tensor times the gradient of p, pressure. We want to know how many dimensions variables we can form. Well, first of all, you have to count your number of variables and call them x1 up till xk. Well, let's count. We have our v depending on x, y, and z, but v is a vector. You have here only scalar variables in the x's, so you have a v1 of x, y, z, and t, v2, and v3. And furthermore, we have our variable p. Let me count. So how many variables do we have? P, v1, v2, v3, x, y, z, and t. So we have k variables. K equals 8 in this case. So we have x1 up to x8. Next step, count the number of parameters in your model. Now, first of all, we have this mu over here. How do we count the permeability matrix? Well, it is a 3x3 matrix. We do not assume anything about symmetry or whatever for this example, just a 3x3 matrix. So we have 9 entries in this matrix. So that means that we have 1 plus 9 equals 10 parameters. So we will have a p1 up till p10. Then, third thing you have to do, count the number of dimensions. Well, we have length, we have mass, and we have time, and that's it. So we have m equals 3 dimensions. And then the theorem of Buckingham tells us how many dimensions variables we can form. That's actually easy. If you have k variables, l parameters, and m dimensions, then you can form k plus l minus m dimensions quantities, which are called q1 up till qk plus l minus m. So in this case, you can form k1 up till k15 dimensionless quantities. And furthermore, the theorem tells us also that all scalar model equations, so all equations from your model, can be converted into a dimensionless form where your f is depending on your dimensional quantities, and your f star can be expressed in all your dimensionless quantities. So Buckingham's theorem tells you, first of all, how many dimensionless quantities you have, and that you also that you can convert all the equations of your problem into dimensionless form.